Hey guys, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to cover our next adapter, which is Azure Storage Adapter. Let's begin. What is Azure Storage Adapter? Azure Storage Adapter is an adapter in SAP CPI that you can use to integrate SAP CPI with Microsoft Azure Cloud. By using this adapter, you can perform various
CRUD operations on
different types of Azure storage services. In Microsoft Azure, we have Blob storage, table storage, queue storage. So you can manipulate these four services by using this Azure storage service. You can use this Azure storage service both on sender side and on receiver side, which means you can read the data from Microsoft Azure Cloud. You can write the data to Microsoft Azure Cloud by using this adapter. Let's now talk about what are the different types of applications that you can integrate by using this adapter. By using this adapter, you can integrate different applications like Microsoft SharePoint, Microsoft Power BI, Microsoft Office 365, and other Microsoft applications to different types of SAP and non-SAP applications by using SAP CPI in between. Let's now talk about what are the do's and don'ts of using Azure Storage Adapter. You can use Azure Storage Adapter to integrate SAP CPI with Microsoft Azure Cloud for reliable and secure communication to extend the data between two different systems. When using Azure Storage Service, you need to make sure you are using the right service on Azure Cloud side. As I mentioned earlier, in Azure Storage, we have four different types of services: Blob Storage, Table Storage, Queue Storage, and file storage. When you want to work with binary files, you have to use Blob storage service. When you want to work with queues, you need to use Azure Storage queue service. When you want to work with structured data, then you have to use table service on Azure Storage Cloud. Similarly, when you want to work with files, then you have to use Azure Storage file service. Based on the client's need and integration requirement, you have to use appropriate service on Azure Storage Service. While implementing integrations, you can use dynamic configurations to manipulate sender and receivers of an Azure Storage Service. Let's now talk about what are the don'ts of using Azure Storage Service. Do not use Azure Storage Adapter for complex message transformations, because typically Azure Storage Service supports
CRUD operations on
Azure Cloud. Do not use Azure Storage Adapter in scenarios like real-time integrations or streaming application integrations, because Azure Storage Adapter is meant for batch and scheduled data exchange. Do not use Azure Storage Adapter when you have scenarios like data encryption and data compression, because right now Azure Storage Adapter doesn't support these features out of the box. Let's talk about what are the configuration parameters that you need to configure a Azure Storage Adapter. To configure a Azure Storage Adapter, we start with connection. In this section, we provide what is a storage account, what is the storage account key, what is the storage account URL, and other connection details. The next part is processing. In the processing section, we indicate what type of service it is. Is it a blob storage service, or a file, or a queue, or a file share? And we also indicate some keys and rows to filter the data out. Let's talk about what are the known issues of using Azure Storage Adapter. Azure Storage Adapter does not support append blob and paste blob storage types. Azure Storage Adapter does not support SAS token authentication method. Azure Storage Service does not support Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2 service. Azure Data Storage Service does not support Azure Data Storage Emulator Service. Also, this adapter does not support Azure Storage Service Explorer tool. And this adapter does not support some features like dynamic blob reading, directory scanning. So that's it about Azure Storage Service. Now for information, I already made a video, which is a longer video, which has a real-time example explanation, where I explained the real-time scenario by using Azure Adapter. If you have time, check out that video. The link is in the description. Hope you like the video. If you like the video, consider giving a like.